Look at that. She's giving Graf nothing to bite on initially. Keeping it low, keeping it hard. Graf, of course, looking for the soft return so she can run round. She's getting none of that.
Barking out the encouragement. Break point. Arachi will be serving with a double break cushion for the title if she gets this point. She says no, says the line judge. And she, Arantxa, wants Anne Lasserre down, and the crowd not too impressed. Sometimes that's the kind of thing that gives Arantxa a bad name.
Yes, I think more than sometimes, but it's. She just wants to win so badly, and one can't fault her for that. And there is, after all, an official to make the final decision.
Deuce, then. Oh. Steffi wanted the same ball back. Very, very few players want the same ball that's gone into the net, back again. Her fifth double. A second break point. As she put that away, Steffi looked up to the heavens and screamed.
Well, it's the best forehand that she's hooked, not this one, the one prior to it, because it set it up. Such relief.
Battling qualities all through this match, but Steffi now is clawing at her. She will not give up this title. Just amazing. And all she's done is hold a serve, and people are standing up around the court. So animated. Not just the players, but everyone who's watched this match. It's hardly been a dull moment. Arantxa Sánchez-Vicario is a breakup, 4-3, deciding set.
Well, I'd like to know what it takes to knock the breath out of Graf. She plays these long rallies. She's at the end of the yo-yo. This is the girl who's dictated it, the woman who's dictated it. And Graf's right back in position. Well, she's still pumping.
Arantxa's grunts are now getting of Monica Seles' proportions. Well, you can see that right off the line. But she's had such little luck with the line calls and the line themselves that she deserves this. Charge from Steffi, but nil percentage there. So here we go. Steffi serving to stay in the match.
And you can see how positively Sanchez just went for that. Certainly not unnerved at all, just her second love game of the match. You sometimes wonder with Graf, just going into point after point after point, not showing any deep breathing at all, not showing any emotion. It sometimes smacks really of a very strict upbringing, almost as if you're not allowed to show that you're tired. And one just wonders sometimes whether she shouldn't just take a little bit more time. Of course, you can not change what you are, certainly not at this stage, not after her phenomenally successful career.
She's reading Graf so well.
Yes, and to be able to read a drop shot, because there haven't been many of them. Graf played a few in the first set. Since then, they've been few and far between. And Sanchez, when it comes to reflex volleys, much more skill than Graf. Well, it's easy to say it, but I believe that had she done a bit more of this earlier on, she might well have been the winner. She had situations where she had Sanchez on the rocks, but wasn't able to capitalize because of her uncertainty at the net.
She will go up and inspect it. but she won't find anything that she'll like. And she's got to gear herself up now to serve for the championship.
Back live to Roland Garros with Peugeot, official partner of the French Open.
Campioni, they were shouting, the Spaniards, during the break. Not that she's not serving for the match. Steffi, sorry for...
That'll be interesting to see how many strokes we have in this game. There's going to be nothing too rapid unless, of course, Graf jumps on a forehand. Nine in the first rally.
Spotted through McMillan. That's exactly it. She talked aggression before the match, and she has played more aggressively than usual. There's one thing doing it through the match, to do it in the final game would be great, wouldn't it?
So 17 in that. No climbing.
Steffi, the wall for the Arantxa, the battering ram.
Yes, and I don't think she really wanted to go into the net at that stage. And once she got caught there, without any sting, without any steam in her volleys, Sanchez, provided she kept her eye on the ball, and she's such a good competitor that she's always likely to.
Arantxa nodding her head, sinking in, that it was long. And here are two break back points for the champion. That was a crisp second serve.
Yes, it took a daring second serve really to break the ice, to break the monotony of losing points when you're serving for the match.
Steffi Graf, do or die stuff from Arantxa, but she was just a little careful. Steffi wasn't, and she's got a reward. She's still in this.
Well, Graf for once had to take a little longer just because the noise was so overwhelming. Sure they could hear that at the Arc de Triomphe. Incidentally, 61 shots in the previous game, 61 strokes it took to break the Sanchez serve.
A crescendo of noise. Nice little volley, and even then it was not over.
Graf just hangs back sometimes behind those inside-out forehands, but if she volleyed earlier, she'd be in better position. And here she's caught defensive, and she was lucky in the end to get away with it. But they read each other's books so well. She understands the Spanish of Sanchez, and Sanchez, for some reason, understands her German.
Oof. Make it difficult for yourself. Again, and it has to beat Sanchez.
Well, I must admit, when I see her playing these shots, and I feel for both of them, somehow my heart drops, because that's more likely to go out than the one that she hits away. Well, when she misses a return, I think it's time to have a party.
Yes, the crowd certainly celebrated. The vast majority are on Steffi's side, despite this amazing will of the Spaniard. Sensed a bit of tiredness there, both with the serve and with the shot. I'm focusing so much on the physical problems that Arantxa might be encountering. Steffi seems to have lost its sting.
Yes, yeah, she's playing it much nearer the middle of the court, and that, of course, is what gave Sanchez hope. She saw a big wide opening here, and she went for it. And one can't blame her. And at least you feel good having missed a shot. I mean, you feel less worse having missed a shot going for it than when you do and it's a tentative thing.
Thank you. Steffi celebrating like she'd won the title there. 6-5 she leads.
Think Sweet, an exceptionally intuitive processor.
Heinz Gunthardt up on his feet, roaring Steffi on. She's just a few feet below him, and she's a game away from the title. Arantxa Sánchez-Vicario at 5-6. There'll be no tiebreak in the third set, of course. Even if Arantxa wins here. 10 minutes ago, she was serving for the match. Now serving to stay in it. She was very confident. It was only about a foot or so off the line. She reacted like it was yards long.
Yeah, she was certainly going in to play it on the fly. And a good bit of judgment. And Graf really found that high bouncing ball. These courts are hard when it is come down at them from a height. It really rebounds back up to a height. Sánchez is so brilliant is in her use of the sand. Because she's smaller, she can slide so well. She doesn't have to. She's almost a skier out there on the clay court. Glides into her shots and hasn't missed many of those jabbed forehands.
Fortune favouring the brave.
Yes, and I think Graf just a little late. She doesn't slide quite as well as Sánchez. Just a little late to make up her mind that she was going to play the defensive lob. As it was, she did a good job to bring it in that close.
Confident was that volley? Vicario claps her hands, but the coach, David de Miguel Lapiedra, looks a picture of misery. I think he's had enough. I can understand how he feels. It's riveting stuff, but it must be so draining if you can only watch, and it means so much to you. 6-6. Steffi not reading her.
Yes, and she briefly lost her bearings and then came up with a badly judged slice backhand, which gave Sánchez all the time in the world.
on the line. Magena Rancher looks for help, but this time, thankfully, doesn't ask Anasair to come down.
Yes, it was one of those inside-out serves and almost an ace, but that's the closest yet we've come to an ace. Chiefly because Sanchez was 3 metres wide of the doubles court when she played the return.
For a split second had her legs stuck and was then working really hard to get them out of the way. It hit her, of course. She'd have lost the point. Root of a serve.
Yes, and what a time to be able to come up with your best serving.
Break point.
Sanchez is looking so solid on the little double-handed hook cross-court shot.
For the second time, Arantxa can serve for the championship. For the second time, she serves for the title. It's 7-6, third set. Nope, just overcooked it.
Well, I know it's intensely pressureful out there, but by her standards, that was an easy volley. Graf had given up the chase.
Well, she's playing this game very differently from the one she played when she served for the set the first time. She was very careful there. Not too many careful shots there.
No, and that's why the first point was so vital, because she's chosen to attack on that one, and then having missed an easy volley, she's suddenly now become a little tentative again.
Steffi still will not give way. 2 hours and 46 minutes. And she has 3 points to make it 7-7. Must have been right on the line. Arantxa accepts it, and Steffi has broken again. And if Steffi does go on to win the title, Arantxa will ask herself a load of questions.
Yeah, she sure will, but it's just that both of them, of course, want it so desperately. And the match now, incidentally, has equaled the longest since the tiebreaker was first introduced in a final. That was the final between Margaret Court and Chris Evert in 1973, 36 games. This one now has gone 36 games. The longest final of all was in 1955, 38 games, so they haven't got far to go.
Oh, lucky Steffi. That smash wasn't anywhere near where she aimed for it.
She certainly didn't collect it in the meat of the racket. It was down near the throat. But fortunately, she checked and got a grip of her own throat first.
The sun smiling, and the gods were smiling on her there. Again, looks up in relief. She wasn't going to get to that if it was an inch the other side.
Right away, she's back ready. She's got to wait for Sanchez, who's not taking unduly long. But of course, Graf's quicksilver between points.
Steffi's ahead once more. When you come back, it'll be a rancher serving to stay in it.
Of the French Open.
Tumultuous noise during the change round, and most of it for Steffi, who once more is a game away from her fifth title here in the French. Arrange at 7-8.
Well, Graf's had her best preparation to break for some time with that service game 1-15. It's a long, long time since she's won one that easily.
Arantxa played this purposely when she's serving for the match. It's one of the great conundrums in sport. It doesn't just apply to her. Very nearly got it round and in, even after 2 hours and 50 minutes. Over the net.
Yes, I actually missed seeing her play the shot. I'm interested to see it again, whether she meant to hit. Yes, she meant to hit it short. That was brilliant style at that stage. Ages since she's played one of those. And of course, she's got the snap and the ability, the technique and the slice to do it.
Thank you. There's no sign of an end to it.
Well, we now know that we're watching history-making, because it's now equaled the longest ever match, which was when Britain's own Angela Mortimer won here in 1955. 38 games, she won 10-8 in the third. Merci. But this has gone now, 38 games.
Un peu de silence, s'il vous plaît. Merci.
The weather, as you can see, is lightened. No danger of rain now. First set.
Yes, and I'm sure Mrs. Graf and Heinz Guntart there are clapping, because they know tennis, and they're clapping not only because Graf has won the point, but because of the resilience that she's meeting, the resistance that she's meeting.
Steffi serving really well again. No. Good of her to try.
No, she's got remarkable skills, but when it comes to hands, Sanchez actually beats her when she has to make a very quick decision. If the decision is drawn out, Graf is phenomenal.
Just a little slow there. But we're looking for signs, perhaps a little bit too much, but there's a moment of tiredness, and why not?
You look at the scoreboard and you feel God must be her on her side, because it says A. Sanchez, Vicar.
Intuitive processor.
Serving to stay in the match once more. 8-9.
Incredible, but a little hurried second serve. And of course, Graf's looking to do a bit of damage on the second serve, looking to run around it, and therefore exposing a lot of the forehand wing.
Long. A weak call. Arantxa looks at her as if to say, come on, louder. It was the right call, but for an agonizing moment she thought it wasn't coming.
Yes, please, at this stage, make it louder and make it quicker.